Hello everybody, this is Walmart Killer, and today I want to be talking about a new game that just came out, and it's just my opinion, but it's going to be my opinion on the new Dark Souls 2, Scholar of the First Sin, PC DirectX 11, 64-bit version of the game, and is it worth it? It cost me $20 because I already had the base game with the DLC, for PC. So the upgrade price for me, as a PC player that had all the shit already, was $20. So that means I bought the game for $59, and then I spent, $30 for the season pass, which gave me everything. So that's $80. And then this now makes it a $100 game. Now I still have the original version of Dark Souls 2. What it does is that I now have two games in my Steam library. One's Dark Souls 2, one's Dark Souls 2 Scholar of the First Sin. Now the original Dark Souls 2 has Scholar of the First Sin content in it, like some of it, but it doesn't have enemy placements. It doesn't have item placements, it doesn't have the updated graphics, it doesn't have the extra NPCs and NPC fighters. And now, one thing FromSoft has mentioned that it has is, the new Scholar of the First Sin has new item placements and all this other bullshit, right? What they didn't tell you, what I've found out, is that they gave some of the enemies different weapons, and I swear they put some new enemies in the game. Like when you go to the wharf area, there's a couple enemies in there that are really quick and have claws on both hands. They look like they're Vega claws from Street Fighter, and I've never seen them before, and I've put over 400 hours in Dark Souls 2. Now, maybe I'm just a scrub and I missed it. Maybe I'm just a casual and I missed them before, but I never saw them in the game before. So there's that. Then in the Iron Keep, and I'll get back to the whole... Don't even get me fucking started on the Iron Keep now, but... And the Iron Keep, there's an enemy there that has different weapons, but it's the same enemy you've faced before, and it makes him way more deadly. So there's that. But, yeah, in addition to that, they made the enemies faster, and they made them way more aggressive. Now, some enemies will chase you to the ends of the earth now, and some of them won't. Some of them will chase you for a while, but they give up like they used to. Some will chase you for a long ways. When you get to the Iron Keep in this version of the game, you are going to hate those alone knights. You're going to freaking hate them. They will chase you for a long time. And when you get to Iron Keep, FromSoft put in two NPC invaders, and they're not the Forlorn. I know about the Forlorn. Yes, they pop up in certain spots here and there, but it is not them. These are random other dudes. They put a lot of extra NPC invaders in. It's almost like it's New Game Plus. That's how it works. There's just a lot of them there. And they don't come back once you kill them. They're gone forever. But they are there. And another thing that they did is they balanced all of the enemies, like their hit points, how much damage they can do. And they also balanced the bosses. Now, what this means is that bosses that you used to cheese and whoop ass on earlier with the same weapons, if you use that same weapon upgraded the same way, you are not going to beat them down the same way. It just won't work. You'll find that the enemies, the bosses in particular, have a lot more health and possibly do more damage, but that's unconfirmed. The health thing, as far as I'm concerned, I've confirmed that myself. I've fought enough bosses now that, yeah, it seems that's the way for me. And also, I had one Lord Vessel that I got early in the game, and I was doing a strength build, and I decided I want to do a dex build, so I just went back and changed my stats real quick with it. I have not found any other Soul Vessels since then. Now, I remember when I first got Dark Souls 2, I was running through the original version of the game, and at one point, I had like 3 or 4 Soul Vessels. It was no problem. This time, uh-uh. You want to hold on to that, because I don't know if you get another Soul Vessel. You probably do, but it's... They're making them harder to get. Also, the DLC for this game, which comes with it automatically, is not instantly unlocked. You can't just go beat Old Iron King and instantly go to the DLC. You cannot. You have to get a key for it. And there's notes that From has written in the game that are on the ground, you know. You check them out. They look like they're written by a regular player. But when you check them out, it says, for instance... the key is in the forest, or something like that. So you have to go to one of the first areas that you go to, the old forest area, and where those lizards are down below with the fire. The key is way down at the bottom in there. You have to get past so many of those lizards, and they are super deadly now. Now, I went down there with a Zweihander that was +7, I want to say, and a lot of health and everything, and I died at least 3 times. Now, this is before I found out where to drop off properly. Most of those deaths were me dropping off in the wrong spot with the cat ring, taking a lot of damage, and then having those lizards spit their fireballs at me. But even when I got down there 2 times, I died twice to the lizards because they shot fireballs at me, and they don't just shoot one and stop. They shoot like 4 in a row now. They're way aggressive, like doof, 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 doof. Maybe even faster than that, maybe slightly slower, I don't know. But they're way more aggressive. Now, I think FromSoft heard everybody complaining about Dark Souls 2. And they were like, oh, it's so easy, it's way easier than Dark Souls 1. Well, they managed to make it harder, but is it harder in a good way? Is it harder in a way that makes the game fun? For me, I've been pondering that question. And I say that, and the last time I looked at the clock, it was 10 o'clock. I look at the clock right now, it's 3 o'clock. I just got done playing for 5 hours straight and didn't even notice the time. So for me, is it fun? Yes. Even in the Iron Keep, which the Iron Keep is crazy bullshit now. Oh my god. I mean, you get 2 NPC invaders in Iron Keep, and the Alone Knights just straight come at you. And there's this area where there's 2, I think there's 4 explosive stacks on the sides, and there's a little skinny platform that you're on. And there's one of those giant Alone Knights that has an electrical sword. He comes at you, right? They put 6 of those explosive fire things there. So now, when he swings at all, it's going to blow up, and it's going to almost certainly kill you unless you have a lot of health. They moved the location of the Zweihander, so now you can't jump across the ledge to get it. You don't even need to jump, it's solid. But you do have to go through probably 5 different Alone Knights that are all coming at you at once, mind. Because as soon as one of them sees you, they just start running at you. And they're already pretty quick. I don't know, man. Maybe it's just that area, but they are really aggressive. I have not beaten the game yet, but I don't know. If you like a challenge, I would say get this version of the game. If you like a game that looks as pretty as it can be, runs at a solid 60 frames per second, no problem, and just is a challenge in every way, shape, or form, where it's like it's intense the whole time now, then I would say get this game. If you tell me that you can run through this game right now as it is and casual the entire game, I want video proof of it, because I'm calling bullshit. There is no way anybody, I don't care how good you are, there is no way anybody is playing through this game and not dying, I don't know, at least 10 times. Not until you've practiced it a bunch. So, is it worth it for me? I'd say it was worth it. Also, Pursuer. I always was disappointed with Pursuer. Because he only appears like, what, 3 times? 4 times? You can fight him in the forest area in 2 different spots. That's twice. But once you kill him, that was it until after you fight Smelter Demon. Then he comes back there. And then that's it also until you go to New Game Plus and you fight him in the throne room. But you fight 2 of them there, right? Okay. So let's do one better. FromSoft decided to make Pursuer. Spoiler alert. FromSoft decided to make Pursuer. I guess I should have said that at the beginning since of the footage I'm putting in. They decided to make Pursuer actually kind of pursue you. Like, he appears in other areas in the game now, even after you kill him. And he's instantly raged and pissed off, probably from you killing him. So, it makes it a lot interesting. Also, the default area at the very beginning when you leave the witches, you can't just go to all the tutorial areas. Some of them are blocked by stone statues. There's a lot of stone statue guys. In fact, going to the ruined sentinels, the door that everybody opens up and it just drops down and runs straight to the boss fight, that is blocked by a stone statue. You need a fragrant branch of yore in order to, you know, dismiss that. And I heard you can also use the blocks also. I can't think of the name of them right now. Anyways, those blocks that you put in the wall that unlock stuff, I heard you could somehow use those. I don't know how, that's just what I heard. I haven't confirmed that at all. That's probably a scrub rumor. But, less soul vessels, more enemies, faster enemies. They're super aggressive. the placements of the enemies, the placement of the items, the improved graphics. I mean, I want to see somebody be able to speedrun this game without any glitches. Speedrun it. I don't know if you can. I don't know if you can now. Trying to speedrun the Iron Keep? Shit, you have to perfect it. You have to perfect it. Those guys, the archers can see you from so far away in Iron Keep now. They can see you from so far away. They just start arching immediately. I mean, it's going to be terrible. I mean, it's going to be bad for you. I know it. And, yeah, the rest of the game, like I said, I haven't beaten it yet, but when you get down to that one area with all the mages, I'm having a brain fart right now, but the one area with all the mages that fire the tracking missiles at you, the tracking little shots, I'm not looking forward to that area, because I wonder what they did, because I know they nerfed those guys on Dark Souls 2 version, but this is supposed to be the definitive how they meant it to be version, and everything is darker and looks better, and the lighting is way better in this game. So ultimately, I would say, pick up this game if you want a challenge. If you were sorely disappointed in Dark Souls 2, and you wanted something to be harder, pick up this game. If Dark Souls 2 was pushing you to your limits, do not buy this game. Do not even look at this game. It'll chew you up and spit you out, this game will. I wonder at this point if this game is harder than Demon's Souls. And I've never played Demon's Souls, so I don't know. Now, it is kind of true that it's kind of cheap because all they're doing is throwing more enemies at you and changing the placement of them and giving them a buff on health and damage. That could be an easy fix to make it tough, but maybe that's what the game was missing. Maybe it needed more enemies. Maybe it needed them to be in better spots to better ambush you. Maybe. I don't know. This is Walmart Killer. I'm out, and thank you for watching my video. Peace.